What we do as researchers, it's not just for the quantitative values that we take from it. Sometimes you get those really amazing stories that are really for more important reasons than we might have originally pictured.
From the moment I met Jasmin, she was so positive. There was something different about her. I always say there's something different about her than every other researcher. She cared and she was genuine.
It's such a joy to be able to see students come out of the graduate student program really proud of what they've created and with the research that they've done. Over the past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of supervising Jasmin Ma. For her dissertation, we conducted a series of projects where she worked with people with spinal cord injury and physiotherapists to develop a physical activity behavioral intervention.
To basically tell us, how do we do this? How do we make sure that we get our clients with spinal cord injury either starting to exercise or continuing to exercise?
I've suffered from PTSD since a vehicle hit me in 2005. I regressed to a point where I was afraid of just about anything and everything. Someone suggested to me that I might get off to a better start if I involved myself with the study that Jasmin was doing. She took the time to talk to me and assess my goals. She looked at the whole person.
So in the graduate program of the School of Health and Exercise Sciences, we aim to provide our graduate students with a unique research training experience. Jasmin has worked so hard on this project, and I'm especially proud of how she has engaged the community of people living with SCI, as well as physiotherapists, to make this project a truly partnered endeavor. And I think that's why the project has been such a success.
The general premise behind it is that we have three key strategies. First one is education. What is physical activity? How do we do it? The second piece is referral. Maybe we're not the best person to get them involved in sport, but we know the right people who are. And the last piece is exercise prescription. So we'd actually write them an exercise program that's adapted for their abilities.
She paired me with someone who lives near me. We found that driving to this building was a barrier. We formed a group called the South Fraser Active Living Group, and since then, with Jasmin's help, we've developed a toolkit that they are hoping to put in all of the City of Surrey's recreation facilities.
Every single one of our clients now are currently exercising and well above the spinal cord injury physical activity guidelines.
I can't believe how far we've made it in 9 months or less.